Hi there. I hope you're having a good day. I'm living on the western side of the mountains here in Colorado. I'm looking at the mountains right now as the sun's beginning to turn to the west to create a sunset for us. But I'm just kind of reflecting upon how there's some amazing things happening in our lives right now. And I was just trying to think of a story that I could tell you because I'm a storyteller. I'm a writer and I'm an artist. And I like to convey the good things in life through story. So my husband and I drove up to the mountains on Sunday. And we drove outside of the city here and drove about 2.5 hours to a mountain town that we go to on occasion. And we ate at a restaurant where we love their food and like their service and just had a really nice dinner. And I'm the one that drove up to the mountains and gave my husband an opportunity to enjoy the scenery and to kind of take things in, things that he normally wouldn't see because he does the driving a lot of times. And then he drove on the way back. And the thing I'm always amazed about is when I have an intention to do something, and it's kind of like, well, let's just go and have some time away and just get out of the city and kind of get away from our normal, the normal things that we do every day and just kind of get away for a while. But there's always something incredible that happens when I do something like that. Almost always, there's almost something. And it's something that kind of freezes you in the middle of time and you see this situation or this offering or you have a conversation with someone and it's just incredible. Well, what we were doing on the way back, and I never know what it's going to be, of course, because you can't design what that's going to be. But on our way back, we were driving back down this long highway, and he was going probably, I don't know, 60 miles an hour, 65 miles an hour down this highway. And I looked to my right, and in this little valley, little small valley area in the shade, were probably 60 or 70 elk. And it was like, oh my gosh, you know, and I'm an animal person. I love animals. So I saw these elk and they were just feeding, having their evening feeding. And oftentimes when I have driven in that valley, I see the elk in the early morning and then in the late evening. So I don't get to see them very often. We sometimes see antelope or you might, and of course you see cattle and people that have cattle there. But this is a valley that was once a seabed here in Colorado millions of years ago, and the Rocky Mountains are one of the older mountain ranges in the world, whereas they used to be taller than the Himalayas are now. So this is a very old part of the world, was once tropical and was once, you know, of course, where the dinosaurs, you know, walked along, and there's a lot of evidence here in Colorado of their existence here. So we have lots and lots of history, and that's fascinating to be a part of. But in the life here, in this particular day that we're driving through, I saw this beautiful herd of elk. And it just kind of reminded me, here they are, this, you could call them a community, so to speak. They're there having their evening meal. They were beautiful. They were strong. They were powerful, just doing what they naturally do. And it just kind of reminded me of what we do, how we naturally gather together in community, and that's what we're being invited to do right now in this greater way with what is happening in the world. With COVID, we can't get together and go out and do things quite as much as we were able to do. So how do we do that? We can gather together online. We can gather together with small groups of people. We can gather together and do what we need to do through social distancing. But it's still about kind of how do we join together in community? How do we gather together? And so that's where the internet comes in. And that's when what I'm trying to do here is to create a new way of doing what I do through the internet. So I'm an artist and I'm a writer and I like to tell story through my paintings and what I do. This is one of them right here behind me. This is actually a painting of what is Daniels Park here in Colorado. And I remember sitting there one evening for probably an hour, hour and a half to try and get the perfect photo. And I spent a lot of time trying to get this perfect photo so I could do this painting. And so then this is the evidence of that. And it was a great, I remember sitting there and just capturing photo after photo after photo and just taking it in and being part of this beautiful sunset. And that's kind of one of the glories of living on this side of the mountains, where we get to see the sunsets over and over again. So life is good, and we really have to look for it when things are challenging us. You know, look for what it is in community. Look for it is in the heart of what it is that you're seeking. Look for it in the love and the peace and the harmony in your life. And be in that place of here and now, where you capture those moments that are moments that you will forever remember, because there's something magical about that. Something magical about that place where we come to this place of, you know, some people call it alignment. I think of being in alignment with the divine, in alignment with life itself, alignment with where right here in this moment of here and now, here's this magical moment. We have magical, wonderful moments from time to time. In every moment of every day, we have a lot to be grateful for, and we are tremendously blessed. And I really believe that we're all in this together. We truly are. And so you have a really good evening. I hope that life is good for you, and I just send you my blessings. And the word blessed means to confer prosperity upon, meaning I wish you all good. I wish you the best. I know for the greater good of life that unfolds, and we just say yes to it. We're all in this together. Enjoy. Good night.